the culture of the Southwest United States, it's very risky to have a cross-border relationship in Arkansas and Marion, Texas. But my kids are half Texan. When they were born at St. Vincent's Hospital in Little Rock, their mother made sure there was a cigar box under the birthing bed that had Texas dirt from the Alamo in it. So I appreciate the chance to be with you, and thank you so much for that warm introduction. It is a pleasure to join my colleagues, including my friend Dave Trott, being here to support the efforts of the Coptic community to have their story told and told thoroughly here in our nation's capital. So I'm gratified that you invited me to come by and provide some remarks. You know, in the second chapter of Matthew, the Lord comes to Joseph and says, "Man, you need to get the heck out of there. King Herod's after you." And that flight to Egypt is such a great part of the traditions of our Christian faith and the roots of Christ's visit to Egypt and the roots of the Coptic Church and St. Mark's future evangelism in Egypt, and all that brings home true the deep relationship that Christians around the world share with our Coptic brothers and sisters. When I was in Cairo in February, it was a rare privilege and an honor for us to meet with the Pope of the Coptic Orthodox Church, and I found that such an inspirational visit. He told us, and I'm sure he's said this many, many times in Egypt, for American consumption, we really appreciated his remarks. And he's famous for having said, "We will pray in the mosque, in the churches, and if they destroy the churches, we'll pray in the mosques. And if they destroy the mosques, we'll pray in the streets." And certainly all of us took that to heart and appreciated the Pope's deep passion and faith for protecting religious freedom in Egypt. He also took something that struck with me that I took home with me. He says, "Egyptians take two things from the Nile, water and a moderate attitude." And that's where I think we have a lot more work to do. I was pleased to see, I'm a Catholic, so I was pleased to see Pope Francis visit Egypt. And I sure agree with his statement, "Let us say once more a firm and clear no every form of violence, vengeance, and hatred carried out in the name of religion or in the name of God." And I appreciate President El-Sisi in making the gestures that he has towards Copts and Protestants by attending Mass with the Coptic Pope on two occasions. As you've heard in Washington this week, words matter. But attacks on the countryside are still, I think, an immense challenge to Egypt. And those victims rarely are seeing any form of justice. So I would hope that President El-Sisi would make an example of security for Egyptian Christians by ending this culture of impunity and persecution, particularly outside the metropolitan region. Further, while the President and the Pope pointed to concrete steps, good steps, towards changes in schooling for Egyptian students, particularly young students, we still need more there. We still need more changes towards acceptance at the primary and secondary school level, and more work to be done there. On behalf of the United States, we're proud of the work that President Trump has done in reestablishing the functioning, working, quality, two-way relationship with the people of Egypt and the government of Egypt. And I think that was made quite clear in the President's recent trip to the Middle East, and quite clear in the warm and cordial meeting here in Washington between President el-Sisi and President Trump. But another area that has a long history in Egypt that we all need to do better on is in the area of non-governmental organizations and their role in civil society in Egypt. I'm a Rotarian. I'm a third-generation Rotarian here in the United States. So my grandfather, after World War II in Little Rock, welcomed young students from Europe as a part of the Marshall Plan in to live and work in Little Rock as a part of Rotary's outreach there in his club. My dad was a Rotarian. I was am currently one, a past president of the Rotary Club. And my daughter, Liza, is down at the University of Texas at Austin. Aggies in the family lost, the Razorbacks in the family lost. She's a Longhorn. She's been involved in Rotary as a young person. So she's the fourth generation in our family to believe in the four-way test of Rotarians. But you know, Egypt was the first country in the Middle East to have a Rotary Club. The Rotary Club went to Cairo in 1929 and was a part of a great tradition in Cairo of welcoming traditions that were from outside Egypt. And so I hope that we can all recognize that there are very valuable resources of our non-governmental organizations that are doing good things around the world, doing good things in Egypt. And let's just take that as an anchor point, that Rotary was welcomed to Egypt in 1929, and Rotary's humanitarian work around the world is unsurpassed. I hope that the el-Sisi government will continue to balance and look for ways to support NGOs working in Egypt that are legitimate and carry out a caring mission that's complementary of what needs to happen in making Egyptian society all that it can be. For the Americans and the Egyptians, maintaining a working relationship with Egypt is essential to solve the crisis in Libya, tackle the issues of terror finance, and helping Egypt further develop its economy. The best thing we can all do in the United States and our business community is engage with Egypt for its strategic location and economic benefits to help grow that economy, offer future career opportunities to Egyptian, and a growing, better Egyptian economy is better for Christians in Egypt and better for so it's a great opportunity for Egypt, also in the world, in this conversation that we're now having about the Middle East of the future, because we are losing an ecumenical tolerant view in Turkey, and that makes Egypt all the more important to play its historic role in having an ecumenical, tolerant, and economically advanced viewpoint for the people of Egypt. So it's an honor to be with you today. Thanks for letting me come by and make some remarks. I appreciate your advocacy on Capitol Hill for the plight of our Christian brothers and sisters in Egypt. Know that we stand with you in Congress for religious tolerance, religious freedom, and that all across the Levant and in Egypt, we want the diversity of religion that has made the Middle East healthy, economically successful, and beautiful place it's been for millennia. And we just won't tolerate this destruction of that rich faith tradition across the Middle East. And God bless you, and thank you for your work.